We're responsible for the capital works and asset management for the district. We take on the developments and replacement of assets across the district. It's a multitude of projects that happen, right from concept design through to delivering, commissioning and handover.
Fundamentally, we aim to better facilities, services across the whole district, that better the experience for staff, patients, visitors, etc. So through the work that we do, we take very seriously and pride in delivering the best outcome, the best product we can through the built environment and the services that support that. So whether it's air conditioning and new clinical areas such as the urgent care centre at Long Jetty and other services. We often have a very limited budget, so it's making that budget stretch as far as possible to get the best outcome for users and ultimately our core business in delivering professional health services to the Central Coast community.
We try to have a lot of fun along the way, and I think we need to do that because we can be in some pretty stressful moments when you're trying to work out problems that arise. So we're able to bounce off each other and have a bit of a laugh and a joke.
It's a real positive environment. We feed off each other. We get through a huge volume of work, and the outcomes and the effort is phenomenal in terms of such a small team.
I think our team's been quite challenged over this year. We've had multiple projects that have had fairly strict delivery times. I think the fact, the sheer volume that we've managed to work through in delivering the program has been a major accomplishment and something I think our team's very proud of.
Our team is responsible for infection prevention and control over the whole of the Central Coast Local Health District. One of the most important parts of that is hand hygiene.
We are also responsible for not only reducing healthcare associated infections, which hand hygiene is obviously a key element in doing, but we're also responsible to ensure that our practices in aseptic technique, our practices in reprocessing and cleaning, disinfection, environmental cleaning, which is very much key to improving our healthcare associated infections and reducing risk to others.
We've been involved in quite a few initiatives and programs lately. So one of them was the Gloves Off program, which is a sustainability and environmental program that also incorporates ensuring hand hygiene is really effective, and this was in Wyong ED. We also have been involved in more hand hygiene auditor workshops, so we've been educating new hand hygiene auditors around the district. Patient outcomes are improved a lot by reducing healthcare associated infections through a lot of what we do. So it's really important for environmental cleaning, hand hygiene, and all the other aspects of an infection control program.
So the goal for our hand hygiene improvement plan was to meet the national benchmark, which is 80% compliance, which we have consistently done for a number of periods. And we're very, very proud of achieving that. We haven't done it on our own. It's not the infection control team that has actually achieved that, it is the district and the staff, and we thank them very much for helping us to reach that goal. The infection prevention and control team are quite a unique team. They've all had different experiences in other roles, which they bring to the team and offer ideas and thoughts on how maybe we could do this a little bit differently.
We're very passionate about what we do. We want to see that our community is looked after and is healthy.
I really look forward to coming to work, and a huge part of that is definitely my team. My team actually make the difference and help me improve things here at the district.
The clinic was set up because there is a high number across the Central Coast of patients with shortness of breath, and a lot of it stems from the chronic respiratory diseases.
So there are some breathlessness clinics around the world and a few in Australia, and it was thought that a breathlessness clinic might help people in the Wyong area to maybe manage their breathlessness and not present to hospital as frequently so that we can keep them at home and keep them well. We will meet together before the client comes in, and we'll have a discussion about what's happening for the client, if they've had recent admissions to hospital or what interventions they've had so far. And we'll also make a plan for what might be useful for the client.
we have the patient one-on-one, and at the same time, they get to see more than one allied health in the one day instead of waiting a period of time. So I think then it all condenses in one day, and we're all getting that same message for the patient. And I think that's why we do see a big difference, is because we are getting that same message.
We definitely do work as a team and respect each other's disciplines and the knowledge that each discipline brings to the issue of breathlessness. We also respect the client's understanding and knowledge and what works for them, and we're really just trying to add to that picture and contribute to that.
I'm proud that we are a team, and I think I'm very proud that we learn from one another. And I get really excited seeing the outcomes of the patients. We see them once a fortnight, and when they come back the second time, there is a big change.
The clinic has had some really great results for clients that have come through. We've seen some people who have come in a wheelchair and really thought that that was it for them, and that they wouldn't be able to do much else with their life and have much quality of life. We only see people for two sessions, and they've come back the next session walking in without the wheelchair. So what we've really heard back from clients is that the clinic has given them hope with their breathlessness.